In this video, we're gonna be answering the age-old question, OSB or plywood? Which one should you use for your roof deck? We're gonna be performing different tests to find the answer. Let's get into it. In this test, I wanna find out how well nails hold onto both OSB and plywood and see which one does a better job grabbing onto nails. The way we're gonna be doing this is I've driven three nails into both this sample of OSB and into a sample of plywood. All three nails are sticking out half an inch and all three nails on both boards are the same thickness and material. That way we have an even test. We're gonna be testing each three nails separately. We're gonna pull on with a scale and see the maximum amount of weight each nail holds, average those out, and get a good comparison between both OSB and plywood. First off, we're gonna test the plywood, then we'll move on to the OSB. All right, so we got 87.7 pounds on the first one. We have 71 pounds on the second test. 72.7 pounds on the third one. Now that we're done testing the CDX plywood, we're gonna be testing the OSB next. For our first result, we have 24.8. We have 17.9. And lastly, we have 13.4. In this test, the plywood is the clear winner, 77.13 versus 28. The OSB, you might have pockets that are weaker, whereas opposed to plywood is made of even and consistent sheets, providing a more uniform surface. Let's move on to our next one. What I wanna test now is the absorption rate of plywood and OSB. Now we're weighing the plywood, so we're at 29 ounces, and the OSB is weighing in at 31 ounces. We're gonna see how much it absorbs in the first 4 hours, then we're gonna give it 3 days. Let's get started. In order to do a fair test, both these are hand cut and more likely to absorb in moisture. And let's place these in. All right, we're about 4 hours into our test. I'm gonna weigh it so we'll know how many ounces of water was absorbed. The second thing I wanna do is measure with a moisture meter the spread of water to see how far water has spread. So let's start off by measuring the OSB. So we're at 33 ounces and we're at 32 ounces of water for the plywood. The plywood has absorbed 3 ounces of water and the OSB just 2. Now let's mark out the spread of water. All right, so what I'm finding here is the moisture's only spread to about an inch above the water line. So our OSB was submerged into water from about here, and so far we have moisture showing an inch above that. Now our plywood, visually I can see that it's already a little bit more than that. So our plywood has traveled in an interesting pattern. You can see a lot farther up, so they were both submerged up to about 2 inches. The plywood pulled up a lot more water, which is what I was expecting. The way trees work is pulls water right from the roots all the way to the top of the tree. So there's essentially veins where OSB has smaller particles of wood. There's not a consistent place for the water to travel. Now we're gonna put these back. We're gonna come back in 3 more days and see over a longer exposure what's gonna happen to both these samples. Both plywood and OSB have been sitting in this water for about 4 days, and now we wanna measure it for the second time to see how much water we've absorbed. We are at 36 ounces for the OSB. Now let's measure the plywood and see. All right, interestingly, we're at 36 ounces for the plywood as well. The OSB hasn't absorbed any more water. It's come up maybe 1/4 of an inch. So you can see here's our line for the first test. This second line here is after 4 days. So the difference is very small. However, the difference in the OSB was even less. Overall, I would say the clear winner in this test is definitely the OSB. It only absorbed 5 ounces of water in 4 days, whereas plywood absorbed 7 ounces of water in 4 days. The spread of OSB was a lot less, whereas plywood spread a lot more. Bottom line, this round goes to OSB. In this test, I'm gonna be putting my health and well-being on the line to answer which is stronger by seeing which one can span further and still hold me up. All right, let's see how this goes. All right, looks like I'm safe on this one. So we've got a 16-inch span. I heard a little bit of cracking, but the plywood is holding up well. It's time to test the OSB. I'm gonna stand in the middle, both my feet on one line right in the center. So glad to say there's no cracking and it seems like I'm safe for now. Now I put the span at 20 inches. Like I gotta say, I am a little bit nervous, but let's see how this goes. Looks like I'm still safe for now. Just hear some little cracking, but that's about it. Now it's time to test the OSB. Again, I'm gonna be standing right in the middle. And looks like I'm safe for now. Next, we're gonna be moving up to 24 inches. All right, now we're at a 24-inch span. I'm gonna put our plywood on and see what happens. 24 inches is the widest generally roof rafters are spanned. All right, looks like I'm safe for now. I'm not moving any of my weight. Again, just I hear light cracking when I'm on the CDX. Now it's turn for OSB. All right, seems like I'm good. I'll be moving up from 24 to 28 inches. All right, I'm getting nervous. All right, now we're at a 28 inch span. Now realistically, this is wider than any standard roof would be. So, all right, a little nervous here. All right, seems like I'm safe for now. All right. I gotta say, both these materials are impressing me. I would have expected a break by now. Next, I'm gonna go to a 32 inch span and see what happens then. All right, we are at 32 inches and ready to test. All right, I am pretty impressed. I'm gonna do a light bounce right now. And it seems like this is holding up well. Time to test the OSB. All right, it seems like this is safe. I'm gonna let light bounce. Next, I wanna move up to 3 feet. So this is quite an extreme span. Still nothing. I'm gonna get a little jump. All right, we got a good bounce there. All right, now it's time to test the 36 inch OSB. There we have it. Plywood spans bigger and longer than the OSB, I guess. I think it's safe to say that plywood takes this round. Now that our tests and experiments are done, it's time to put our thoughts together and see which one takes the lead. Plywood is stronger. However, that to me is not as important because we're spanning between rafters that range between 12 to 24 inches. Both of these perform just fine. So the results of that test was interesting, but I wouldn't say it weighs my decision or my opinion too heavily on the side of plywood. The next test we did was the nail pull test. Plywood did take clear win. However, to me, I don't think it's a huge indicator of which one's better. If we're gonna have blow off, it's usually gonna be the shingles that blow off and the nails that stay. The next test we did, which in my opinion is huge, is which one absorbed more water, and OSB was a clear winner of that. And again, we can see that OSB only took in a little bit of water while plywood absorbed a lot more and absorbed more weight. So anytime we're replacing an OSB roof, what we see is small sections get damaged, small sections get replaced, and we're ready to move on. What we see in plywood, anytime there's a leak, entire sheet get damaged, or half a sheet, or 2-3 sheets in that whole area need to be replaced. So in my opinion, this test is a real world application. OSB takes the lead. That's one reason I think OSB is gonna be the superior product. The other item that we were not able to test was what we call delamination. If we have a roof that's maybe 40, 50 years old, we find heavy delamination that we have to replace the entire plywood because the sheets of the plywood are delaminating, meaning they're coming apart. I think why this happens more often on plywood than it does on OSB is because if one sheet starts failing, that entire sheet can start opening up. As opposed to OSB, if one of these small chips fail, your failure is limited to just one location because you have so many strands of wood that are coming together. If one part of it's failing, it doesn't mean the entire sheet fails. On the other hand, plywood fails as a sheet. Lastly, we have termites. Plywood, you have thick sheets of wood that are glued together. Termites don't like glue, they don't like chemicals, they like natural wood. And plywood, you have a lot more wood for termites to eat than you do on OSB. Termites will kind of burrow in between the plies and will eat out the plywood. I don't think I've ever seen OSB being eaten by termites. If all things were equal and you're gonna be installing new sheeting on your roof, I would personally pick OSB. If you think I'm wrong, let me know below. I would love to hear why you think plywood beats OSB.